Hey, computational thinking. In this video, I'm going to introduce our first major project of the year, which is building a magic 8-ball in Python. Now, if you've never seen one of these before, I'll explain how it works. It's pretty straightforward, but this is a really fun project, and I look forward to seeing what you all come up with. So the first thing you might be asking yourself is, what exactly is a magic 8-ball? Some of you have probably played with one of these before as a kid, or maybe you've seen one sitting around somewhere at Target or Walmart or whatever. But essentially, what a magic 8-ball is a little toy that you flip it over and you ask it a yes or no question like, am I going to go outside today? And you shake it, and then a little pyramid will pop up with a response on it, and right here it says, don't count on it. And it's got several random responses. I think it has maybe 12 to 16 random responses. So we can ask it another question like, will I play my guitar today? And it says, let me turn it around so you can see, it says, signs point to yes. And we can keep shaking the ball and getting answers and responses as long as we want to, and keep asking yes or no questions of this magic 8-ball. So what you're gonna do with this project is you're gonna simulate the behavior of a magic 8-ball using Python. And to do that, you're gonna need a list of random responses that you come up with. So that magic 8-ball would say something like outlook not so good. You can say funny things that you come up with on your own. I encourage you to be creative with your responses and make it something you enjoy seeing, okay? And then you're gonna need a way of getting the user, getting them to ask a yes or no question. And once they ask that yes or no question, you're gonna get a random response from your Pythonic magic 8-ball. And that program's gonna keep running. We're gonna let them keep shaking the ball, so to speak. And getting responses until they decide that they are done and they want to put the ball back down on the table. So in this project, you're going to be simulating the behavior of the magic 8-ball. And what that means is that you will need to build a list of random responses that you come up with on your own. They can be funny. They don't have to be the same responses that a magic 8-ball would give. And you also need a way of choosing from those responses randomly. You'll also have to let the user ask a yes or no question of the magic 8-ball, and then respond to them with a randomly chosen response. You'll also want a way of keeping the program going until the user wants to stop. Now you might be wondering, what does it look like when this Pythonic magic 8-ball is running? And I want to show you. So I'll go ahead and run my program, and it's going to say ask a yes or no question or type Q to quit. So I'll ask a yes or no question like, am I a grizzly bear? Outlook not so good on that. What do you know? And let's ask another question. Let's say, is this coffee hot? Absolutely not. And it's not. What do you know? This computer's very smart. Okay, so we've asked it a couple questions. We're saying, you know, we're done with this thing for right now, so we'll go ahead and type Q to quit. And our program ends. So this is what Magic 8-Ball looks like when it's running. We ask a yes or no question. The computer gives us a response back. We ask another yes or no question, the computer gives us another random response, and then when we want to quit, we can just type Q, and the program will end. That's the Magic 8-Ball project. Make sure you check out the project guide for more information. Obviously, we haven't covered everything in class that we need for this project quite yet, but I wanted to put it out there so that if you are ready to get started, you can. If not, stick around for more stuff from class, and you'll be prepared by next week to start the Magic 8-Ball project. I look forward to seeing what you come up with.